Hi, it's Mike Chen. We've talked a lot about really weird and interesting mummies who were monks on this channel, and here's another one. Take a look at this. At the Dinghui Temple in Wuhan in the Hubei province of China, a golden mummy, the preserved remains of Master Ci Xian that is over 1,000 years old, underwent a CT scan a couple of weeks ago, and to everyone's surprise, and by everyone I mean a gathering of fellow monks, doctors, and media, through the CT scan, researchers found that Master Ci Xian still had a complete brain and that his bones were also really healthy. According to Dr. Wu Yongqing, who conducted the scan, the upper jaw, the upper teeth, the ribs, the spine, and all the joints are all complete. It's incredible to see this. According to historical records, Master Ci Xian, a well-respected monk from India, had translated 10 major sutras into Chinese and traveled from India to the Kingdom of Khitan, which is in modern-day northeastern China, in an effort to promote Buddhism. Some of his translations were even carved into stone tablets and can still be seen today. And here's where it's really interesting. After his death, Master Ci Xian's disciples preserved his body, but then over the years, they kind of lost it. His body was rediscovered in a cave in the 1970s and was transported to Dinghui Temple, where it was worshipped since 2011. And in 2016, the temple covered his body in gold paint as a sign of respect. And then, of course, like I mentioned at the beginning of this video, a CT scan was conducted a couple weeks ago, which found that amazingly, Master Ci Xian still had healthy bones and a complete brain, which usually just dries up and shrink during mummification. And the way that monks in ancient China go about the mummification process is also really interesting because they do it through very natural means. According to Master Du at the Dinghui Temple, elderly monks can feel when they're about to pass away and then will instruct their disciples on whether they want their remains to be cremated or preserved, and if they choose preservation, their remains will be placed in a massive ceramic jar, which is then filled with some sort of natural preservatives. And it is believed that if the spiritual level of the monk is high enough, meaning that there is a lot of cultivated energy within the monk's body, then after 3 years of soaking in the liquid, the body should still be in relatively good shape. And if that is the case, then the monk's body will be removed from the liquid and covered in rice paste. Now, this may seem really strange to a lot of people, but it is believed in Buddhism that all monks are cultivators with the goal of reaching enlightenment. And as they are cultivating, they are generating energy within their own body. So as the energy grows, it will start to change the cultivator's body from a fundamental level. And this is why oftentimes when monks who were said to have cultivated to a very high level, little white pearl or bead-like substances is left behind in the ashes when he is cremated. The pearls are called sarira and are considered sacred and precious and not even from this world. Also, throughout history in its billions of cremated bodies, it was only high-level cultivators who were able to leave sariras behind. So yeah, I personally do believe that Master Ci Xian's cultivated energy has a lot to do with why his body is still much, I guess, healthier than other 1,000-year-old guys. And if you guys want to read up more about cultivation and about sarira, I'll link some information for you in the comments below. Also, guys, I want to give a shout out to this new science channel called The Friendly Brain, which is started by a friend of mine, and I absolutely adore it. And if you love random knowledge, if you love facts, you love sciencey stuff, I think you will as well. I've linked one of the videos for you right here, so check it out. I'll also have the link for you in the description box below. Thank you all so much for watching. I'll see you later.